Security code review of a big code base is very difficult. In the beginning, you are just overwhelmed by the amount of things you don't understand. However, there are things you can do to make it easier and find more bugs by reviewing the code. In this video, I will show them on the example of my bug in Golang's HTML parser, which is in scope of Google Open Source Bug Bounty. Enjoy! The first step is understanding on a high level what are you reviewing. I usually do this by just using the product and by reading the documentation. But by no means this one step is enough to make a complex code base easy to review, especially here when we are talking about HTML parser, because HTML is extremely complex with hundreds of states, with namespaces, different parsing rules. But the fact that the whole library is complex doesn't mean that every single line does crazy things. The whole library is composed of many small pieces which by themselves are easy to understand. And the first thing that I do when I'm jumping to reviewing a code like this is I find a small piece like this, a piece that fits onto a single screen, and I try to understand what happens there. This gives my brain the signal that it's not as overwhelming as I initially thought, and this does not have to lead me to a bug straight away. Let's be honest, when I'm approaching a target like this, I am not hoping to find an easy bounty in one day, especially that I am not an HTML expert or an XSS god. The code I stumbled upon is this function that's used to parse HTML comments. This is how HTML comments normally look like. And you may be wondering, what's the point of messing up with comments? What could I potentially achieve? So imagine I have a website where I allow users to use simple HTML in their descriptions. For simplicity, let's only allow header tags. So I write some code that takes the description from the user, parses the HTML, and checks whether all tags that are in this HTML are allowed or not. If they are not, I forbid the user from saving this description. If they are, I consider this description safe and I show it to other users where this HTML is being parsed in their browsers. So the HTML is parsed twice. Once by my code, which uses Golang's HTML parser, and then by the browser of my potential victim. If I can find any inconsistency between these parsers, I can hide some XSS payloads so that the validator doesn't see those payloads, but they are executed in the browsers in the context of the victim. When you are looking for bugs in libraries like this, you have to come up with these attack scenarios yourself. Just make sure that you are using the library correctly, because if you misuse it, you will not be rewarded. So let's come back to the comment syntax. This is the typical comment, but the specifications of how parsers should parse the comments mention a few exceptions. One rule says that if a greater than character is immediately after the beginning, this is considered an empty comment. Another rule says that if a comment is closed with this sequence with the exclamation mark inside, it is also considered a valid comment closing. And Golang library had no problems with applying these two rules. But tell me, what do you think should happen with this? If you combine the logic from these two rules, you should interpret this as a valid empty comment. However, there is nothing in the specification saying that these two can be used together. It means this is only a comment opening, and that's also how browsers process this. But Golang's HTML parser saw this as an empty comment. So if I use a payload like this, then my hypothetical validator would see an empty comment first, and then an H1 tag with some attributes, which are considered safe so this description would be allowed. But then it would be shown to users and processed by their browsers. And the browser would see here only a comment opening, and the H1 tag would be the comment's content. Then the comment would be closed and the rest would be processed as valid HTML. This way, we smuggled an A tag past the validator, and the XSS can execute in the victim's browser if they click on this link. Google paid me over $3,000 for this bug. If you want to learn more about XSSs, check out this video with some of my conclusions after studying 174 bug bounty XSS reports. For now, thank you for watching and goodbye.